Hello everyone. So in this video, we are going to see the flowchart for Simpson's one-third rule. So with starting here, start the program. Start. Next step is to define the function that is y equal to f of x. Example y which is equal to e raised to x, so defining function that is y equal to f of x. Next step is to find out, or we have to read the values of lower limit, upper limit and number of steps. Here read x0, xn and n values. So that is nothing but the lower limit, upper limit and number of strips. Okay, next we have to check the number of strips and either it is multiple of 2 or not. Okay, so for that, while mode, that is n comma 2 equal to 0, if yes, then we have to read n again, if no, then we have to go further. So it means that we have to check the number of strips and either it is a multiple of 2 or not. If n is not a multiple of 2, then enter the new value. So if this it is not multiple of 2, then we have to go and we have to go for new value of n, so it should be multiple of 2. Okay, so if it is multiple of 2, you have to go for next step and you have to find out the value for h, that is you have to calculate the step size h, which is equal to xn minus x0 divided by n, and I will consider this result should be equal to 0. So result means nothing but res notification. I have given one notification for result res, which is equal to 0. Okay, so it means that you have to calculate the number of value of step size, and formula is xn minus x0 divided by n, and initially I have put on the result as 0. So further I will continue this flowchart here. Okay, so next is to find the value of y from 1 to n minus 1. So for that you have to use for loop. For I equal to 1 is to n minus 1. Okay, you have to check y term is a multiple of 2 or not. For that you have to use this if statement. If mod I 2, which is equal to 0. Okay, if yes, means this is not a multiple of 2, so you have to go for result, which is equal to res plus 4 into f of x0 plus I into h. Okay, and if yeah, if no, so it is multiple of 2, so it means as res plus 2 f of x0 plus I into h. Okay, so it is depend on the value of y from 1 is to n minus 1. You have to check the term y is multiple of 2 or not. If y is not a multiple of 2, then we have to calculate a new result in this way. And if the value term is a multiple of 2, then we have to calculate result in this term. Okay, next step is I will consider one temporary, I will notification as temporary value, that is temp f of x0 plus f of xn, that is nothing but the y0 plus yn. So this value I have to find out. I consider this value as a f of x0 plus f of xn, so that is nothing but the temp. Next step, you have to find out the area with the help of Simpson's one-third rule. So area is equal to h by 3, you have to multiply this factor to result plus temp. Okay, so this is nothing but the Simpson's 1/3 rule cross section area formula. Next step is to print the value of area, print area, and at last the program will be end. Okay, so this is important here. So h by 3 into bracket result res. So res is either this or either this. Okay, next temp value is this, that is y0 plus yn. Okay, and at last we have to add this in the process and you have to find out value of area and print the value of area. At last the program or flowchart will end. So I hope you understood this flowchart. Thank you. Thanks for watching.